the word muffin appeared in Britain around the 11th century. In Victorian times, muffins were bought in the street from the Muffin Man, made famous in the popular children's nursery rhyme. In America, cooks began to experiment with English muffin recipes, and the modern muffin was born. These muffins are a lot like homemade ones, except to make this many, you need some pretty big equipment and a whole heap of ingredients. At this commercial bakery, they make them with flour, then add salt, baking powder, and a prepared mixture of dry ingredients. Finally, they add vanilla flavour and start up the barrel mixer. It's a big one, large enough to hold a ton of batter. Next, they add oil and water, then vegetable shortening. Now here come the blueberries. They go into the mix once they're thawed. Berries are delicate, so workers take care to pour them out slowly, weighing each bucket to add just the right amount. Down below, workers pour out the batter from the mixer. One batch makes about 7,000 muffins. They cover the trough to protect the batter until it goes to fill baking pans, like these that can hold 54 muffins, each with its own paper liner. A conveyor advances the pans towards a machine called a batter depositor. Prepared batter pumps in from the trough and into the pans as they pass below it. The depositor fills the pans one row at a time, measuring out the batter by weight. At the next station, blueberries pass through a funnel equipped with a turning gear and drop right onto the muffin tops. A bar placed across the conveyor blows filtered air to remove any stray berries from the pans as they advance to a gas oven. Metal arm pushes them in to bake for 30 minutes. The oven, open on both sides, has dampers to keep in the heat. The muffins come out of the oven, baked to golden brown. The pans cool for a few minutes and then continue onto a custom designed machine that's pretty handy. It removes the muffins from the pan and packages them all automatically. Suction cups seize cardboard flats two at a time and push them onto a tray former. The forming head pushes down on the pre-glued cardboard and voila, out comes a perfectly square box that falls right onto the conveyor belt. Pans full of baked muffins follow alongside on another conveyor. At the next stop, suction cups lift the muffins out of their pans. They set them down into neat rows in the cardboard boxes that wait on the back conveyor. The conveyor carries the filled boxes to a station where they're covered, top and bottom, with a sheet of clear plastic. Heated blades cut and seal the plastic at both ends. Then the boxes pass through a heat tunnel that shrinks the plastic snugly over the trays. They're now ready for shipping. On another line, pre-printed plastic film wraps the individual muffins as they flow along a conveyor. Brushes keep them moving forward, while blades come down to separate the continuous roll into individually wrapped muffins, ready for sale.